a desperate attempt to shore up unified European support amid escalating violence. UN-backed Libyan leader Fayez al-Sarraj will begin a series of meetings with European leaders on Tuesday. He will first meet with Italy's Giuseppe Conte before talks with Angela Merkel in Berlin and Emmanuel Macron in Paris. The EU has thus far failed to back a joint political solution to the crisis. While European leaders theoretically support al-Sarraj's government of national accord, the Libyan leader has accused France of backing Haftar's Libyan National Army, accusations Paris denies. As European leaders struggle to unite, the risk of a full-blown civil war is only growing. Speaking through the Libyan National Army spokesman on Sunday, General Haftar urged his troops to wipe out all opposition forces, despite the United Nations call for a Ramadan ceasefire.
Our battles against terrorism in the past, in Benghazi and Derna, did not stop for the holy month of Ramadan, but increased our determination and strength during this holy month. Officers and soldiers in our armed forces and the support forces, I salute you during these glorious days and urge you with your strength and determination to teach the enemy a greater and bigger lesson than the previous ones.
On April 4th, Khalifa Haftar launched an offensive on the Libyan capital of Tripoli, setting off a steep escalation in violence. In response, forces backing Sarraj's government of national accord launched a counteroffensive, leading to a stubborn but bloody stalemate on the outskirts of the capital. The recent wave of fighting has left more than 400 people dead, over 200 injured, and some 55,000 others displaced.